So Laplace transform of, write the heading, Laplace transform of integrals. Laplace transform of integrals. In this topic, we will discuss one or two problems. Find the Laplace transform of. Already we have discussed one problem, but here in the Laplace transform already we discussed, but it is a different problem. Find the Laplace transform of. Find the Laplace transform of e power minus t integral over 0 to t t cos t dt. Laplace transform of e power minus t integral over 0 to t t cos t dt. See, we know that Laplace transform of, what is the Laplace transform of 0 to t f of t dt is equal to f of s by s. So what is Laplace transform of 0 to t t cos t dt? T cos t dt, Laplace transform of t cos t dt. So 1 by s, that is equal to Laplace transform of t cos t by s. So what is Laplace transform of t cos t? We know the formula, a square minus s square by a square plus s square whole square, where a equal to 1. T cos a t means this is the formula. So t cos t means a square minus s square, a square plus s square whole square, when a equal to 1. You have to remember the formula, this step. So here 1 minus s square divided by a square plus s square, sorry, 1 plus s square whole square, a square minus s square divided by this, check it, s square, a square minus s square, or a s square minus s square. I think this s square minus s square. S square minus 1. S square minus 1 divided by 1 plus s square whole square. And then we need to find that, so 0 to t f of s by s na into 1 by s, 1 by s. But we have to find that Laplace transform of e power minus t, Laplace transform of e power minus t integral over 0 to t t cos t dt. So that is equal to 1 by s into s square minus 1 divided by 1 plus s square whole square per s test to s plus 1. So what is the answer? 1 by s plus 1, s plus 1 whole square minus 1 divided by 1 plus s plus 1 whole square. Square. Okay, expand and simplify that. You will get the answer. So what do you get? S square plus 2s divided by s plus 1 into s square plus 2s plus 2 whole square. Write one note. L inverse of e power minus as f of s that is equal to L inverse of e power minus as f of s equal to L inverse of f of s L inverse of f of s where t tends to t minus a. This one important MCQ. L inverse of e power minus a is f of s equal to L inverse of f of s where t tends to t minus a. Find L inverse of e power minus 2s divided by s square plus 4s plus 13. 4s plus 13. Then how can we do that? So what is f of s here? 1 by s square plus 4s plus 13. We need to find f of t. F of t means L inverse of f of s. L inverse of f of s. So, what is L inverse here? 1 by s square plus 4s plus 13. That is equal to L inverse of 1 by s square plus 4s प्लस 4 प्लस 9, एल इनवर्स, एल इनवर्स था 1 by s plus 2 whole square plus 3 square. So what is f of t here? F of t equal to e power minus 2t sine 3t by 3. E power minus 2t using that change of scale property, not change of scale, shifting theorem. S plus 2 is e power minus 2t, then s tends to s. 1 by s square plus 3 square is that sine 3t by 3. So it is f of t. Then after finding that f of t, what we'll do? L inverse of f of s. So what is L inverse of f of s? Here e power minus 2t. Therefore, L inverse of e power minus 2s divided by s square plus 4s plus 13, that is equal to L inverse of f of s is f of t. F of t is e power minus 2t sine 3t by 3, where t tends to t minus 2. T tends to t minus 2. Therefore, what is the final answer for this? E power minus 2 t minus 2 sine 3 t minus 2 by 3 is the answer for this. Where t is greater than 2. Here add one value where t is greater than a for this. Fine. L inverse of L inverse of e power minus s by s plus 1 into s plus 3. So here first we have to find that inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s plus 1, s plus 3. Okay, in the last class we have done this by partial fraction method. That is L inverse of e power minus s, L inverse of e power minus a t, sorry, a s f of s equal to L inverse of f of s, where s tends to, sorry, t tends to t minus a. therefore L inverse of e power minus s by s plus 1 s plus 3 equal to L inverse of 1 by s plus 1 s plus 3, where t tends to t minus 1. Where t is greater than 1. Now, L inverse of, what is L inverse of 1 by s plus 1 s plus 3? First, we have to calculate 1 by s plus 1 s plus 3, that is equal to a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 3. 1 equal to a into s plus 3 plus b into s plus 1. When s equal to minus 3, b equal to minus 1 by 2. When s equal to minus 1, a equal to 1 by 2. So, L inverse of, taking 1 by 2 outside, 1 by s plus 1 minus 1 by s plus 3, where t tends to t minus 1. So, 1 by 2 e power minus t minus e power minus 3t, where t tends to t minus 1. So, 1 by 2 e power minus t minus 1 t minus 1. Fine. L inverse of e power minus 3s tan inverse s. E power minus 3s tan inverse s. How to find that for the inverse, in case if it is inverse and log has come, we have to find in the different format. So what is the rule to find that? First you have to write that L of L inverse of e power minus 3 is tan inverse of s, that is L inverse of e power minus 3 is tan inverse s equal to L inverse of tan inverse s where t tends to t minus 3. So how to find that L inverse of tan inverse of s? We know that Laplace transform of t f of t equal to minus d by ds of f of s. So t f of t equal to minus L inverse of d by ds of f of s. Similarly here, t f of t equal to minus L inverse of d by ds of tan inverse s equal to, that is minus L inverse minus d by ds of tan inverse of s is 1 by 1 plus s square, 1 by 1 plus s square, and then L inverse. So if you are taking that f of t is, if you are taking this as f of t, L inverse of tan inverse of s is f of t, then we will get that f of t equal to, we need only f of t na, so taking that cross multiply the t here, what is minus 1 by 1 plus s square, that is sin s, sorry, sin t. So 1 sin t by t is the L inverse of, here we will write, L inverse of, so this type of problem is important. This is one different problem. L inverse of tan inverse of S equal to sin T by T. But we need that L inverse of e power minus 3 as tan inverse of S. Therefore, L inverse of e power minus 3 as tan inverse of S equal to sin t by t, where t tends to t minus 3. So sin t minus 3 by t minus 3. This is the answer. Okay. Where t is greater than problem for practice. Problems for practice. Laplace inverse of e power minus s by s square into s square plus 1, second one, L inverse of e power minus 2s divided by s into s square plus 4 initial and final value theorem. Initial and final value theorem. First we write that. Initial value theorem. Initial value theorem. The Laplace transform of f of t statement and f dash of t exist. F dash of t exist and L of f of t equal to f of s. The L of f of t equal to f of s, then limit t tends to 0 f of t equal to limit s tends to infinity f of s. Limit s tends to infinity s into f of s. How to write the proof for this? Let L of f dash of t. Actually, I have given the formula L of f of t, f dash of t, f double dash of t, f triple dash of t, everything. That is Laplace transform of derivatives. One important formula, L of f dash of t equal to L of s into L of f of t minus f of 0. S into L of f of t minus f of 0. That is, what is L of f of t? You are given that L of f of t equal to f of s na. So s into f of s minus f of 0. That is L of f dash of t. Taking limit on both sides, s tends to infinity. Taking limit on both sides, s tends to infinity. Both sides distance to infinity. So L of limit distance to infinity L of f dash of t equal to limit distance to infinity s into f of s minus limit distance to infinity f of 0. So what is L of f dash of t? Limit s tends to infinity எல்லா f dash of t is integral over 0 to infinity e power minus s t f dash of t dt. That is equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of s minus, even if you are substituting it is f of t na, s tends to infinity, there is no s here. Simply we can write that f of 0. So when that limit s tends to infinity is dt, there is no relation with the 0 to infinity f dash of t dt. Taking the limit inside, integral over 0 to infinity limit s tends to infinity e power minus st f dash of t dt. So that is equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of s minus, this can be written as limit t tends to 0 f of t. But if limit s tends to infinity here, e power minus infinity 0. So 0 equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of s minus limit t tends to 0 f of t. Taking to that side, limit t tends to 0 f of t equal to limit s tends to infinity s into f of, this is the proof of initial value theorem. Please stop recording.